This was another chapter which requires a lot of practice. Several sub-chapters which I'll be listing out. First is how to measure angles, which is covered under measurement of angles.
Wait, that's the special chapter based on
measurement of angles means we're mostly talking about radians, right? Because radians is something which is very new to us. I already given a brief about it during the bridge course, but for the benefit of Yash, we'll be repeating it quickly once again today. Next is the concept of trigonometric ratios for allied angles. Okay? You are already aware of all the trigonometric ratios for angles like 0, 30, 45, 60, 90. But you are not aware of angles which are beyond 90, 120, 150, 210. Of course, you learn that at school and also officially do it with you also. Next is we are going to talk about compound angle formulae. Then we are going to talk about transformation formulae. Then we are going to talk about multiple and sub-multiple angles formulae. No, I am giving you an overview of the topic. Then we are going to talk about conditional identities. Then we are going to talk about maximum and minimum values of trigonometric expressions.
So did we already cover that to an extended graphs?
No, we didn't cover a sine x plus b cos x plus c more.
Oh, that.
Then we talk about
at least.
Okay? Trigonometry has a huge bulk of your class 11 the huge bulk is covered up by conic sections, which is made up of circles, ellipse, parabola, hyperbola, and pair of triangles. Now, of course, I am covering it with respect to KVPY and JEE and all syllabus. So, of course, I will be taking more time as compared to the school. So, don't think about my school day finishes in two classes and I am taking 5 minutes to do it. Because the importance is like that. So, this is what we are going to study. So, let us first start with the concept of measurement of angles. Okay. Now, as I already discussed with you in your bridge course, and I will do it yet again, right? First of all, what is an angle? Angle is basically a parameter which is trapped between two rays, okay? Where if you rotate a ray from initial position to the final position, the parameter trapped in between is called an angle. Normally represented by Greek alphabet theta, right? You can also say the ray can be moved down as well, right? So let's say if this is the initial position of the ray and this is the terminal position, that means this angle theta has been generated by rotating this ray in an anti-clockwise direction, correct? So this is anti-clockwise rotation. Such angles are considered positive angles by convention. Okay. Is that okay? So if let's say I have rotated it by 30 degrees to reach from initial to terminal position, I will call this angle plus 30 degrees. On the other hand, if I rotate my initial to final position or terminal position in clockwise sense like this, let's say this is the terminal position, then this angle theta would be a negative angle. So clockwise rotation means you are generating a negative angle. So this would be called as, let's say this angle magnitude is 30 degrees, then we would call such angle as negative 30 degrees.
So this is just a convention.
This is just a convention. Correct? So even angles have sign now. When will an angle be positive? When you are generating that angle by rotating the ray in anti-clockwise fashion. So if I keep rotating it like this, I can keep generate any angle I want. Yes or no? So let's say I rotate it like this, I get 90 degrees, rotate it like this, 180 degrees, 270, 360, 450, 540, 630, keep on going like this. Are you getting this point? So this is how you can rotate it in this direction to get positive. On the other hand, if I start rotating like this, minus 90, minus 180, minus 270, minus 360, minus 450, like that. Right? So we can go to any extent in terms of measuring a positive angle or a negative angle just by rotating a ray about the initial point O. Okay. Soon I will be superimposing it with the coordinate axes, the coordinates. Again, repeating the same concept which we did in the fish class. How many units, or what are the units in which angles are measured? There are normally 3 units of measurement of angles or 3 system of measurement of angles.
Degree, grade, and radian.
Yes. System of measurement of angles. Please note it down. There are 3 system of measurement of degree of angles. One is called the sexagesimal system, which was given to us by the Britishers. In sexagesimal system, one right angle is broken up as 90 degrees, 1 degree is broken up as 60 minutes, pronounced as, written as minutes, 1 minute is broken as 60 seconds,
It came from Babylon. From Babylon.
The British came up with this system. Next is the centesimal system. Centesimal system was given by French. Here one right angle is broken as 100 grades. One grade is broken as 100 minutes. And 1 minute is broken as 100 seconds. No. Just for your information. Either JEE or school will ask you such questions.
Sir, this is easy. I've written it already.
And finally, you have another system which is called the circular system.
Yeah, we don't use it. Yeah, it was like some crazy.
Circular system? No, I can't mention it. In circular system, angles is measured in terms of radians. Okay. Let me quickly take you through radians. I know you already are aware of it. Right? Yes. Can you explain what is the radian?
So the radian is the angle between the arc and the
arc.
Absolutely correct. So basically you take a circle of a given radius r, and if there is an arc over here whose length is same as the radius of the circle, then we say that such an arc will subtend one's radian at the center of the circle, written as one superscript with c. The c stands for the circular system. Okay. So if I have two r, let's say this is again an R, then how much will be this entire thing? 2 radians. Correct? So if you make this as, let's say, length L, then how much radian will it subtend at the center? L by R radians. So the number of radians measured is done by the ratio of the arc length to the radius of the circle. Is that okay? Now, if I take the arc length and the entire circle circumference, we will say the same. Yeah, the angle separated at the center is 2 pi radians, and 2 pi radians can now be compared with 360 degrees. So 2 pi radians is 360 degrees. So 1 radian or 1 pi radian or pi radian is 180 degrees. Going forward, I will drop this C superscript. So when I say pi radians, means I am referring to 180 degrees. Pi by 2, I am referring to 90 degrees. Pi by 3, I am referring to 60 degrees. Pi by 4, 45 degrees. Pi by 6, 30 degrees. And so on and so forth. Pi by 12 is? 15 degrees. Okay. Is that okay? 7 pi by 6 is how much? 210 degrees. Is that okay? Now, let us take some initial problems that can be asked on system of measurement of angles, and in particular asked on circular system. Can I get this? My first question to you all is, my first question to you all is, find one radians correct to degrees, minutes and seconds.
In terms of pi?
Yeah, you can use your pi value to be
180. No.
3.14. If you want, you can use your phone calculators for that. I want you to remember that value. Find one radian.
57.324.
Alright, now anybody has a calculator or a phone which has a calculator, just do 180 by 3.14. What are the
57.3248.
Okay.
I did 3.14.
Now, once again, can you just round it off to this?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, see, how do I convert this degrees to minutes and radians? The approach, listen to this. This means 57 complete degrees and 0.325 degrees, correct? Yes or no? Convert this to minutes by multiplying this with 16. All of you, tell me 0.325 into 16. How much is it? 90.5 minutes. 90.5 minutes is as good as saying 19 complete minutes plus 0.5 minutes. 0.5 minutes multiplied again with 16 to convert it to seconds, so it will be 30 seconds. So what I want you to know is 1 radian is approximately 57 degrees, 19 minutes, approximately 30 seconds. Is that okay? Don't forget this. Another important thing is, how much is 1 degree in terms of radians? Right? Just check.
3.14
by 180.
So 0.0175.
Please remember these values because they can be useful in some exams. So 1 radian is 57 degrees, 19 minutes, 30 seconds approximately. And 1 degree is 0.0175 radians.
1 degree is?
0.0. 1 degree is 0.0175 radians. And 1 radian is 57 degrees.
0.0175
makes 5. The arc of that circle divides the the triangle into two parts of equal area. The arc of the circle divides the triangle into two parts of equal area. How long is the radius of the circle? So if it is theta cross multiplication theta into pi r square by 2 pi, so it's 1 by 2 r square theta. So 1 by 2 r square into theta. So theta should be radius. Is that okay? So 2 gone, one of the poles will go off of there. So your answer will be So this will become 12 root 3 by pi is equal to r square. So r will be under the root of 12 root 3
by if we make like a single thing, we can take everything.
What happened? Vishal? Area of this particular sector is exactly half the area of the square. Half the area of the triangle. So half area of the triangle is 2 times area of the sector. Correct. And area of the sector is half r square theta, theta expressed in radians. Remember this, theta here should be in radians, not in degrees. So you know it's an equilateral triangle, so this has to be pi by 3 radians, and that's what I use to get my R. Did I say not as clear?
I am.
Next. Next problem. A horse is tied to a post by a rope. If the horse moves along a circular path, always keeping the rope tight, and describes 88 meters
and describes
88 meters.
So, can you repeat the
question?
What do you mean
by describe? I'll repeat the question once again. One of Niranjan or Omkar, go to that last match. Niranjan or Omkar? Then good luck.
Forever.
Go, go, go.
Forever among parents.
Advert. Come here. I don't know what all the teachers are saying. You people are very good in studies, but very talkative. Why? The last thing that you want to, you are coming here spending 4 good hours just to learn, right? Talking is just going to just kill that thing. It's going to defeat the purpose. Right? Okay. A horse is tied to a post by a rope. If the horse moves along a circular path, always keeping the rope tight, and describes 88 meters. When I say 88 meters, it is describing on the circumference of the circle, tracing an angle of 72 degrees at the center. Then find the length of the rope. Right. Find the point. Huh? Answer. Correct.
So, it's sweeps an angle of 72 degrees.
72 degrees, correct.
Okay, fine. And then 72 degrees.